Once again, welcome to all of you in my YouTube channel Tech Knowledge. Today in this session we will discuss about third topic, that is apply formatting feature. This is session number 3 in unit digital documentation. In this session we will discuss these many topics today, from here to here. Right. First is page style dialog. Second is format text, means removing manual formatting, then common text formatting, then changing text case. Next is superscript and subscript. Next topic is formatting paragraph, means indenting paragraph. Next, aligning paragraph, font color, highlighting and background color. Next is using bullet and numbering, and after that assigning colors, borders and background to a paragraph. These many topics we have discussed today, and then remaining topics of this session we will discuss after in the next video. This video will cover in a part 1 or part 2 mainly. So this is the part 1 and then second one is the part 2. Is it clear? So start one by one. First one is open your document like this. This is our document and see this theory session. Formatting a document. The first step in document preparation is to use page setup. Means before making a document, first you have to set your page. Means its appearance, like it will appear in A3 page or A4 page, letter page or something else like this. So how can you do this? You will get this one when you go to the format and there is a page option, format menu, select page option. Once you click on page option, the page style dialog box will appear. There are so many tabs, but the second tab is related to the page. So here page format, first is page format. So many page formats are available, but we want to select only A4. A4, like A4, A3, A6, A5, letter, see the change. When I select A6 page, so see the change. It look like this, but basically in every where we use A4 document. Clear? Then second is orientation of the page. Orientation, two orientation we have. Then first one is portrait and second one is landscape. When you select landscape, means its width is more than its length. Or in case of portrait, here the length is more than width. Clear? So this is much better for us. Then so many options are available, you can set according to your wish, according to your requirement. Okay, then you click on OK button, see the change. This is the first, means before writing your document, first you have to prepare your document, means page setup. The page formatting is explained in the next section, but the document preparation page setup is taken here. To set up a page, select, click, format, page setup and page option. Once you click on page option, you will get page style dialog box. Its appearance is like this. The dialog box is look like this. The format is A4. Then there are two orientation, portrait, landscape. Portrait means their length is more than width. Or when you select landscape, their width is more than length. Clear? Then have click on OK. See, the description is given here. It allows to select paper size and format. Paper size and format like A4, A5, B4, letter, like this. Its orientation as a portrait or a landscape. User can set the margins. Margins means like left margin, right margin, top and down margin. So you can move from here, from the page style dialog box. Is it clear? Next is formatting text. According to syllabus, next is formatting text. So second topic is formatting text. Formatting text refer to formatting of paragraphs and characters, means either character formatting or a paragraph formatting. To do the formatting, first select the text and then apply the required formatting feature. Formatting feature, like you want to change your style of the font, change its size, change its color, background color, like this. So you can do with the help of this feature. Now, there are various methods of formatting text. We can apply any one method as per the suitability. These are, first, use the menu option from the menu bar. Clear? Use the menu option from the menu bar. Suppose you want to do character formatting. So what you will do? Select the word, paragraph, where you want to apply formatting, and then click on format, where you want to do formatting. Character formatting or paragraph formatting. Here in this case, I want to do character formatting. Select character. Now character formatting. If you want to change its style, like from Times New Roman or something else, then typeface. Typeface means bold, italic, underline. Size of the font, like this. Language you want to change, then effect. If you want to change its effect, means font color, you can do here. Strike through, underline, like this. Shadow, outline, whatever you want to do, you can do from here. So this is from the menu bar. Clear? The first method is use the menu option from the menu bar. Menu bar means go to the format menu and select character, either character formatting or paragraph formatting. Second is use the readily available buttons on the formatting toolbar. Now see, this is a formatting toolbar. This one is a formatting toolbar. From here you can change like font style, then size, then bold, italic, underline, alignment, either left align, center align, right align, justify line, then bullet and numbering, then like this, then font color, highlighted color, fill color means background color, like this. So you can apply from here also. This is the ready made feature. Clear? These options available under formatting toolbar. Next is use the context menu. Context menu means select your word and then right click. Right click, again you will get same font size, size of the font, like this style, bold, italic, underline, like this, alignment, left hand. So all these features you will get from the context menus also. Context menu appear when you select the word or paragraph and then right click on it. Clear? See, right click. Okay. Then third, next method is use the keyboard shortcut. Keyboard shortcut means I want to make this selected text as bold. So what I will do? I have to press Ctrl with B. This is the shortcut key. Remove this, Ctrl B again. Italic, Ctrl B I. Ctrl U underline. Like this. So you can do by using shortcut key also. Clear? Then remove manual formatting. To see the effect of formatting the text, first remove manual formatting. For this, select the text and choose Format and Clear Direct. Formatting from the menu bar, click on Clear Direct Formatting button on the formatting toolbar. How do this? Select your word, then go to the format. And then default formatting option. Once you default formatting, so here previously it is in bold, but now after selecting default formatting, it bold feature is removed from this selected text. Clear? Then next, by using shortcut menu Ctrl plus M from the keyboard, you can do it will clear the existing formatting on the text, and then you can apply the fresh formatting feature. Okay, then common text formatting. These are the common text formatting features, like changing font size. You know very well how to change font size. Font size, like select your text, then go to the font size option from the toolbar, either toolbar, menu bar, or shortcut menu, this context menu, like this. Clear? Similarly, changing font style, bold, italic, underline, changing font type, selecting font drop down menu, changing font color, selecting font color icon. So you can do all these. Bold, italic, underline, like this, bold, italic, underline, font color, like this. Is it clear? So all these you can do with the help of either formatting toolbar, context menu, or from the menu bar. This is the basic text formatting features. Next, this some you can do this with the help of shortcut menu To apply any of the effect, bold, italic, underline, first select the text, then press the desired button on the formatting toolbar. The keyboard shortcut for bold is Ctrl plus V, italic Ctrl plus I, and underline Ctrl plus Q. Like this, you can do. Then, next, changing text case. Case means uppercase to lowercase, lowercase to uppercase, capitalize case, sentence case, toggle case. So, these are the four cases available. See, first you have to select your word and then go to the format, and there is change case option. In the change case, we have five change case options. First is sentence case, then lowercase. Do one by one. Lowercase. Once you select lowercase, then all the word appear in lowercase. Clear? Then second, uppercase. It means all the characters converted to lowercase, from lowercase to uppercase. Similarly, sentence case. Sentence case means first word of the sentence is capital and remain all are small. Then next is toggle case. Toggle case means first letter is small and remain all are capital. Like this. This is the change case option. Then superscript and subscript. Superscript, subscript is useful when you are writing formulas related to the mathematical formulas or chemical reactions. Suppose you want to write chemical formula of water, so it is like H2O. What you will do? You want to move this 2 at the bottom of H. So select this 2 and then go to the format menu, and then what you will do? Character formatting, and then character formatting, from here you have to select position, so subscript, and then click on OK button. Now 2 will appear at the bottom of H. Similarly, if you want to write formula like A plus B whole power 2, so whole power 2 will appear at the power of 2. What you will do? Go to the format again, then character formatting, then select position, and here superscript. Click OK. Now see, 2 is appear as a power of A plus B. Clear? Next topic is your using the bullets and numbering. Bullets and numbering means, bullets means unordered list, or numbering means ordered list. When you want to generate a list, for that time you have to use the concept of bullet and numbering. Suppose that I want to create measuring units of computer memory. Units of computer memory. So what I will do? Now I want to write units of computer memory, means measuring units of computer memory, in a bulleted manner. So select this bullets option from the formatting toolbar. Select this option and then write, like the smallest is bit, then second one is nibble, then third one is byte, like kilobyte, like this. So this is called bulleted list. Or in place of that, suppose I want to create numbered list, means direction, so direction, like select ordered list, means called numbered list, select this, and then once you select this numbered list, then bullet and numbering toolbar will appear. East, west, north, south. And suppose that you want to create or generate sub list of this east, direction east. So what you will do, you have to place here cursor and press tab key. Once you press tab key like this, it makes different list, different sub list. That it's 1, 2, 3. Now here one first is also one set, it's sub list, it appears as one. So how we will make change? How we will make change? If you want to make change in the bulleted numbering, you have to select this and select its type. Select this type from the outline. Either you have to select 1, then sublist is 1.1, and then its sublist is like A, and then it's sublisted in a bulleted manner dot dot, or you can select like second one. First is A, then like this. Then if you want to select this one option, you can select. So it depends on you which you want to select. I want to select the second one. Select this second outline and then click OK. Now see change. First is A, then its sub menu is, sub part is A, B, C, like this. Then main list is 2 and then clear. So you can do change from this option, or you can get this bullet and numbering from the menu bar, that formatting menu, and select bullets and numbering option. Is it clear? From here you can also do changes. Once you click on format and then bullet and numbering, you will get dialog box like this, and first tab is bullets and the number type is like this. Clear? Outline is like this, graphics something different like this. If you want, so graphics is only for when you are creating your bulleted list, means without numbers. Then position, position means level, total we have 1 to 10 levels, then followed by tab stop. Tab stop means when you press tab key, so it will generate label. Label means first time we have in first level, and then press tab key, then move to the another level, means sub level, second level, then third level, like this. Clear? That's all for today. I hope this many topics, these many topics are clear to you. Today I explained page style dialog box, formatting text, removing manual formatting, common text formatting, change text case, superscript, subscript, formatting paragraphs. These many topics we have discussed earlier also. So you can watch my previous videos, and then using bullets and numbering. Till here we have discussed. Okay. Thank you, class.